Hello. Today I'm going to be reading a story that was given to us by a well-meaning relative for our little girl. It teaches all the wrong things. So let's get into it. This one's called The Bear Who Would Not Share. And look at that snooty bear with his cupcake on those poor animals who are not allowed it. So, The Bear Who Would Not Share, written by Oakley Graham and Lizzie Walkley. Bear had spent the whole morning baking cakes and had covered them in yummy icing. They looked and smelled amazing. Bear was admiring his cakes when there was a loud knock on his front door. Wonder who that is. "Hello, Bear," said Owl. "I was flying by and I couldn't help but notice the delicious smell coming from your house. I don't suppose you would share one of your yummy cakes covered in icing with me," said Owl, as he peered at the cakes in the window. "No," said Bear. As Bear started to clean up the mess that he had made whilst baking, there was a second knock on his front door. "That's strange," said Bear. "I don't usually have so many visitors." Bear opened the door and was surprised to see that Fox was on his doorstep. "There's Fox." "Hello, Bear," said Fox. "I was walking by and I couldn't help but notice the delicious smell coming from your house. I don't suppose that you would share one of your yummy cakes covered in icing with me," said Fox, as he spied the cakes in the kitchen. "No," said Bear. Bear went back to cleaning the kitchen and had almost finished when he heard the sound of knocking on his front door again. "Hello, Bear," said Rabbit. "Where's Rabbit?" "I was hopping by, and I couldn't help but notice the delicious smell coming from your house. I don't suppose that you would share one of your yummy cakes covered in icing with me," said Rabbit, as he admired the cakes on display. "No," said Bear. News of Bear's yummy cakes covered in icing quickly spread throughout the neighborhood, and many of Bear's friends came to visit him. "No, no, no. No!" After a busy morning of baking, Bear was feeling very tired. He stopped to admire his cakes once more, then went upstairs to have a nap. When Bear woke up from his nap, he was very hungry indeed, as bears are. He couldn't wait to eat one of his yummy cakes covered in icing. But when he got downstairs, Bear could not believe his eyes. The yummy cakes covered in icing were gone. Bear raced outside. "Rabbit, have you seen my yummy cakes covered in icing?" "No," Rabbit said with a full face. "Fox, have you seen my yummy cakes covered in icing?" "No," said Fox with a full face. "Owl, have you seen my yummy cakes covered in icing?" "No," said Owl with sticky cream and crumbs all over him. Then Bear saw his cub, Little Bear, holding one of the yummy cakes covered in icing. Little Bear had seen the cakes and had decided to share them with his friends. Although Little Bear should have asked if he could share the cakes, Bear could not be angry with him, seeing all of the happy faces covered in icing. Bear realized that it was good to share. "I don't suppose you would consider sharing some of your yummy cakes covered in icing with me," said Bear as he admired the last cake that Little Bear was holding. "Yes," Little Bear replied. Now, obviously, sharing is a good idea to some degree. But this book, unfortunately, at the same time, is making out that this daddy bear, after putting lots of work into creating something beautiful, you might say, is now required to give it all away. And if he doesn't give it all away, it's going to be stolen from him. And then he has to beg for it back in return. It's just the front cover says enough. This snooty bear who's, been greedy. And all these poor victimless animals in the background here, victimless, probably not a word, but you know what I mean, in the background here, feeling really sorry for themselves because of such a horrible individual bear that's stealing all the collective resources that he probably works very hard for. This is also another meme in our society. It must be, to some degree, an attack on masculinity because men are supposed to be very greedy and selfish, and that's just totally a bad thing for everyone. But also, he seems to be a stay-at-home dad, wears little bear's mummy, and he's baking all day. Very masculine things to do. Now, I bake occasionally. I don't think there's a problem with that. But the whole story is about this bear who's baking cakes. Yeah, regressive cultural nonsense that is programming our children to think regressively and nonsensically. So keep an eye out for books like this. This is how it gets in. This is how kids grow up becoming bloody Marxists. No good.